Two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. And here comes a return from just... And look at this! Right away, a loose football. And it looked like he was able to get it back. So a big sigh of relief there, as that would have been a disastrous way to start this ball game. Throwing on first down. Man. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down. Up the middle they go. Horn. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is third and seven. Back to throw. Man. And he can't escape, and down he goes. He couldn't get away there on third down. The pressure too much, and he's sacked for a loss of 12.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. Here comes the Lions punter now. He'll kick it away after a three and out on the opening drive of the game. So just a three-yard return following a punt of 45. And out will come the offense as they take over. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. And leading them out, their signal caller. Now it is fourth season in the NFL.
And in some ways, he's awfully fortunate to get another shot right here in these playoffs because he wasn't particularly sharp in the wild card victory. The ball ended up in the hands of the opponents a few too many times when he threw it. It goes without saying in this one, cannot give the ball away. If he does, the road's going to end right here for him and his team.
Second down and eight. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
And when you get into the divisional round of the playoffs, this is where having the ability to run the football is such an advantage. The defenses, they're generally going to be tougher the further you go along. So if you can get something established up front, it's going to give you a great chance to move out.
Now a second and 10. Gun. They'll look to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Looking left side, he's got it, complete. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 17-yard line.
Pretty solid opening drive here, Charles. They worked in the run game, the pass game, just steadily getting yards, and now they've got it inside the red zone here with an opportunity.
And the only thing they don't have so far is points. But the way that they're moving the ball now, that shouldn't take much longer. And they've established a great balance so far, running, passing, doing what they want on offense.
Now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
It's pretty early in the game, but they've already tried to establish him not just as a runner, but as a receiver as well. Didn't happen there, but I wouldn't be surprised at all to see them try again shortly.
And he's eaten up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16. Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
McPherson's kick is good, and that'll make it 3-0 here in the first. A lot of energy in this building tonight, but the opening drive produces three, maybe quiets them just a bit, at least momentarily.
Just a little, right? That's all you're asking for, right? Things just getting started. You know they haven't taken the momentum totally here, but at the same time, they like what they've done here in the early going.
And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
Back onto the field come the Lions for their second overall drive.
And on the first drive, three and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Ball on the 28-yard line. Here's second and six. Looking to throw. Man, he's got a man. It's his fullback. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup. Now I think we're going to get a timeout here. Yes, a timeout here as it looks like we've got a Lion that's shaken up. The medical staff is going to come out here and take a look, and we will take a short break. On third and two, man, pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's going to have the Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
On first down, man. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And this one too low.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third.
One first down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
Here comes the Lions punter now as he'll kick it away for the second time. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback. Back out comes San Antonio.
And for them, maybe a little carryover from last week's game. They got the win on the road in the wild card round, on the road here again in the divisional round, but they're hanging tough.
Hey, cue a little music, right? A little on the road again. I mean, this has been kind of the mantra they're under right now, and they can't change it. The season dictated what would happen with them, right? They had to go on the road for the first round for the playoffs. They're on the road again, and sometimes teams get really comfortable with that. Not only the idea of going on the road and shocking the world, but just, hey, it's just us. We don't have to worry about outside distractions. It's just us. Let's go play.
It becomes that us against the world mentality, doesn't it?
And while it may be overplayed, you know, in the media, it's real when it comes time to play ball.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll keep it on the ground. Monroe, and he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard. From the 34-yard line, here's a second down and 9. Now back to throw. Going right side here, and that's complete. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And it brings up 3rd and 5 now. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. They're going to look to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
That is certainly one way to frustrate a quarterback. One of those extra defenders on the field. Dime package, lots of speed, no space to fit in the football.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Fair catch called for and made at the 16 or maybe the 17-yard line. A 41-yard punt there with no return, and the Lions will take over. Now a play fake here on first down. He finds his man complete. It's Parsons. So the completion good for 6 yards, and it's second down. They run the counter. Horn
takes this to the 27. Give him 4 yards. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to move the sticks with a gain of 4 on 3rd and inches. Back to throw. Man. Now that's to the left sideline and incomplete.
And I can see the officials kind of looking at each other down there, silently wondering, does this meet the level of grounding? Fortunately, he did have a receiver in the area, but I have seen less obvious throwaways called as penalties.
Another throw on 2nd down, and this one incomplete as well.
Excellent defensive effort to get to him and provide a little contact before the catch could be made cleanly.
Off play action. Man rolling to his right. And he is stopped just short on 3rd down. Got 9 yards, but needed 10.
That was a good effort there, trying to do it on his own. But as a defender, you're in a tough spot because you have coverage responsibilities behind you. And if you take off too quick to try and get him down, he might loft it over your head.
So better to track with your man defensively than try to go up and make a stop on the quarterback.
Exactly right. What you're hoping is that your guys in the front 7 can get him down.
Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. And now this offense comes back out onto the field. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Blitz coming, and down he goes. They overload him that time with a safety blitz, and he winds up being dropped for a loss of 7. Tall task ahead of him here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Too wide and incomplete.
That's well done defensively. They get the pressure they needed on 3rd down. All the receivers are locked up tight, and they force that quarterback to just throw it away.
44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. It's a 40-yard punt, 4 yards on the return, and they will take over 1st and 10. And Detroit getting set to go now. So far, they've had 3 drives, 3 punts. Not good.
Not good indeed, because you've got to have something to show for being out on the field. Now, sometimes, if you have a game where neither side has scored, 3 punts isn't a bad thing. But when you're trying to set the pace, get up on top in a game, you've got to show better offense and find a way to put some points on the board.
He'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's 2nd down.
Now, that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football, led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
The clock running here. Under a minute to go now in the first quarter of a 3-0 game. To throw on 2nd down. Man. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now 3rd down. Looking to throw. Man. And that is incomplete. Now the pressure there on 3rd down, forcing the errant pass. 4th down coming up.
Well, this first half has not gone according to plan so far, offensively, or even defensively for that matter. They could use a big-time spark somewhere, but it's not going to come on this drive as they have to punt this one away.
So possession goes over here on the punt, and it will be 1st and 10 as they take over. Back out comes San Antonio. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start 1st and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of four. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to start them out when you do that.
Second quarter now, San Antonio in possession as they've got it with a third down coming up. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. He had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
I like the calmness of how he played the ball here. No panic in his eyes as that throw arrived. Tracked it from the moment it left the quarterback's hand, and that's just where he needed to be to knock it away.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And it's fielded at the 34. Call that a 41-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. Detroit's offense ready to take over. See if they can put this drive in the end zone, Charles, because it's been a little bit of a rough go at times. They've had to punt the football a ton in this ball game because of stalled out drives.
So are you saying that you're kind of tired of seeing the punter run out there and do his thing during this game? Is that what you're trying to say?
I'm okay with it. I have a feeling that this offense, they don't want to see the punter again.
And frankly, the punter doesn't want to run out there anymore himself. He would love to see his offense put together a drive and give his leg a rest.
Now a dump off here complete. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays,
there he goes, right side. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That's a 3rd down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play.
That's a pretty good throw on the curl route there. 3rd down, and they pick up a first.
Defense should be aware for that, right?
They should be aware, but it's so hard sometimes.
Yeah, it's not easy.
Because when they sell that route really well, you think they're going upfield, then they curl back, show their numbers to the quarterback, and complete the play.
Back to throw again. And his throw is going to be incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
A 2nd down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Now throwing on 3rd down there, but he cannot connect.
And based on my math, they've only converted 1 time thus far in this game, so you can see the frustration starting to come out a little bit. 3rd downs, they've been a problem for them all game. They've got to start becoming solutions.
And the 10-year vet knocks it to the goalpost, and that will tie us at 3-3. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration. Now it's seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny when we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right, baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Back out comes San Antonio. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalpost, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
On 1st down, Monroe. And slow going there as he'll only get a yard, maybe, up to the 41. And we're at the 41, 2nd and 9. Back to throw. Over the middle, it's complete. Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6. And now it's 3rd and 3. throw. And he's caught. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now a handoff up the middle. Monroe. And how about the quick feet there as he made a man miss on his way to a solid gain of 7.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Second and 3. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And it's caught. Touchdown. A great play there. 39 yards. And his guys have taken the lead.
They went 5 wide in that offensive set. And racing, going 3 wide is a big deal. To go 5, how about the way that they finish things off?
Did you just fit a race car reference into the game?
Zoom, zoom. How about the way that you play? When you go 5 wide, that means you're going fast now.
Zoom, zoom indeed. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the lead is now 10-3. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Taken at the goal line. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Time for another look at this Lions offense. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them 3. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now, the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it. And he goes out and gets the job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely, no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well. Now a throw here to his running back. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. It's a gain of 14 and a first down for Detroit.
They certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
On first and 10, man. He finds his man complete. That's Black. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Another strong gain on the last 2 plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. Again, he'll drop to throw. His throw incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught, they got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Well, that's good for a first down. There's a guy who went over 1,000 yards receiving in the regular season, and now he's got his first catch of the playoffs. And the slot man goes in motion left. They'll run on first down. Horn. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Second and 10. At the 21-yard line. Here's a fake on the jet sweep, and instead a give up the middle. Now I think we're going to get a timeout here. Yes, a timeout here as it looks like we've got a Lion that's shaken up. So as the medical staff takes a look, we'll step aside. The offense on third down tonight, they've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This will be 3rd and 5. Back to throw. Man. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And the Lions are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Well, we always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers. I think this guy has a connection with just about everyone. Didn't mind throwing it in there against double coverage to him.
Shows some confidence, supreme confidence.
Big-time confidence that he would make the play for him, and he did.
And he is not able to get away. Sacked back at the 22.
Not the first and goal play they drew up. Multiple defenders in to bring him down to the ground. These sacks now, they're starting to pile up, Charles. And that front seven defensively, they've had their way with this offensive line.
And I think at this stage, we have to start thinking about different play calls. We've got to start helping this quarterback out because the entire game, he's been under siege. I don't care what the down and distance, they've got to get the ball out of his hands a lot quicker.
Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. Oh, and this one, it may need to go back to the drawing board. He's going to be swallowed up right away. They lose two on that last play, so things get even tougher. Third and long coming up. Looking to throw. Man, a quick throw there is incomplete.
Well, so a drive that spans all that time, and yet you may only come away with 3 points here.
Well, your defense, all right, they actually like these long drives. They get to rest over on the sidelines for a while. But when you're not finishing with points in terms of touchdowns, that's frustrating. They've got to figure out how to close out these long drives and get sixes instead of threes.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one-possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
Out is their quarterback with this offense to take over once more. He threw a touchdown pass last time they had it. And he'll look to get him in the end zone again here as they start with the first down.
And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. On first down, Monroe.
He'll get a yard, that's all, as they get him down at the 28. Second and nine.
He'll look to throw.
Throw out wide is incomplete.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. They'll set up to throw.
Able to find the open man. That's complete.
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Two catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered. But how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
They'll run on first down. Monroe.
52 yards rushing for him now as he has been strong here in the first half of this divisional round matchup.
We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman standing by at Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete.
They'll wind up getting just a yard out of it, and it's second down. They'll set up a throw. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. Behind the gain is the 33 on third down. To throw here. And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And this one will sail out of bounds. It'll depend on the spot here. And the side judge says that went out at the 7-yard line. Now the Lions' offense, they get ready to head back out there.
It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Just a gain of a couple there. And it'll be second down.
Two yards on the pickup. It's second
to throw. Man.
Looking for his running back, and he's got it.
And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line.
A gain of 8 there on the play.
And they'll be faced with a 3rd and inches.
Operating from the gun.
Man, he's got his target. That's complete.
And he is going to have a Lions first down, as that'll be a pickup of about 5 as they convert on 3rd and inches.
They'll look to throw again.
And that's going to be incomplete.
A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they threw it. Now with the short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. And the Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33.
Looking to throw.
Man.
Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
They try to throw on 2nd down, but this one is incomplete.
And that's the knowledge you gain from being in this league for a long time. He's learned the hard way when to give up and fight another down. And that's a smart move to throw it away.
To throw on 3rd down.
Man.
In trouble, and he's taken down. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts.
So as they talk it over, we step aside.
The call for a fair catch, and it's made at about the 23-yard line. Final 10 seconds of the half as they've got it 1st and 10.
And they're just going to run it here up the middle.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard.
So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, this is the 2nd of 4 games this weekend as we narrow the field down to the 4 teams who will meet in the league championship games next Sunday. We'll get back out to you guys in just a moment. But first, let's take a look ahead to tomorrow's other divisional round game in the NFC. And it looks like we've got a good one.
This fielded right at the goal line. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. And this offense ready to go to begin this 3rd quarter. And they've been the better of the 2 teams through 2 quarters of play, much to the chagrin of this home crowd.
Yeah, this score is a surprise to a lot of folks at home, although not to my dad. He predicted the visitors would win. And maybe to the folks in the stadium. But you know who is not a surprise to, partner? This team with the football. They were very confident coming in.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
He'll drop to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it brings up 3rd and 5 now.
They'll look to throw.
Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete.
And he's going to be a yard short. Needed 4, but got 3.
Yeah, and on 3rd down, you know those pass rushers, they're in the starter's block. They're just waiting for the pistol to fire. You can almost hear the defensive coaches on the sideline pre-snap. Watch the screen, watch the screen. Really good job there of identifying it and making the play to force 4th down.
It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. So we get a look at the Lions offense as they get ready for their first possession of the 2nd half. And, Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the 1st half. Now that their defense has done its job, It's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
It's pretty evident that this passing game has been frustrated so far. They haven't really moved the ball the way we might have expected, but this is a good pickup here for the first down.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. Back to throw. Man, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Now this offense back out and set to go for their next drive. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag, punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now what you're looking for is can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. Here's second and 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. That'll leave them with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Now come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Third down, Monroe, and he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
I think I saw a lot of shoulders just drop there, and what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be second down. Here's a second and 8. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Looking downfield, and that's caught right side. He's got his man. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. A big play on the catch and run, covering 34 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10, just outside the 30. They're going to look to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. This gain not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. Back to throw now on first down. Throwing the slant pattern here, complete. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Now a second and 2. They'll look to throw here. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's going to be taken down right at the 10-yard line. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. It used to be occasional, right? Safety valve. Throw one to him every so.
Oh, he put it on the carpet, a fumble. Oh, and one of the linemen on the other side has got it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
I don't know about you, but I'm going to go to the positive side this time. Yeah, there was a fumble at the end of this one, but what a sustained drive. And if they keep stringing those together, you got to like their chances.
And credit the defense, though. You're out there for that long, you start to get tired, but they were able to get the turnover.
Did you just credit the defense?
I like to credit the defense and the offense.
I like you.
And the analysts.
That's perfect.
Following the fumble recovery, man. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. Looking to throw. Man, throwing the out route and complete. That's Parsons. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. They'll get a dozen there, and the Lions have a first down. Off the play fake. Man, over the middle, complete. It's Parsons. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Another first down as they call his number again. He's got 15 yards here. Off play action. Man. My rifle's one, and that's going to be intercepted. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
And now this offense comes back out onto the field. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Up the middle they go. Monroe, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Now following the completion, we're going to get a stoppage here for an injury. Hopefully, obviously, nothing serious here. Medical staff, though, are going to take a peek, and we'll take a break. 3rd and 2. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. It'll be a gain of just a yard, and that's going to make it 4th down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Blocked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back, but how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a 4th down?
And he'll be touched out here, but not before he does pick up the first. Now a handoff up the middle. Monroe. And they're knocking on the door now as a good run there. Going to take this to about the 10-yard line. 78 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. So not quite a first and goal. It's 1st and 10 from the 10. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time.
He'll try again with the arm here on 2nd down. And an off-balance throw there, and it's going to wind up incomplete.
And when you're in a one-score game in the 2nd half, now's not the time to force the football to places where you shouldn't. And that's a smart decision to just get that one out of there.
And it's caught. Touchdown. From 10 yards out. And the Steamers add 6 to their lead. Circle that drive because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
McPherson on for the point after. It's good, and now it's an 11-point lead, 17-6.
So that drive in total, 8 plays.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. And Detroit back in possession of the football. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, and some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes and get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Back to the air on second down.
Man.
And his throw is incomplete.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting frustrated. Here we are into the third quarter, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync. Thus far, that hasn't happened. They're looking for answers both on the sidelines and in the huddle looking at each other.
On third down,
man.
And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete.
Looks like another empty possession offensively. And you're at that point in the game where you can't afford too many more of these. So this is going to require some heavy thinking on the sideline to figure out what they can do to crack this defense.
He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. Fielded just inside the 30. It's a net of 40 there. Punt of 48 and a return of 8.
Now this offense back out and set to go for their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other. And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Now a throw here, hold in. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On play action, they'll throw. And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still 2 more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down. Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. Back to throw. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And it's going to be another first down as he'll get him to the ground at the Lions 21. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
But they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets 2 more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
That's a big force incompletion there to bring up third and long. This defense can still salvage a little momentum by forcing them to kick a field goal because just a few plays ago, it looked like they were headed towards the end zone.
The decision to tuck and run gets him 3, but that's not enough. Now it's 4. One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now at Ford Field as we are just about set to go here in quarter number 4.
McPherson's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So that maybe not a knockout blow, but I suppose certainly every little bit helps when you're trying to salt one away in the fourth.
Well, the possibility of being beaten by two late touchdowns or at least sent to overtime does exist, but time, definitely a big factor at this stage of the game, is in their favor.
And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And this could be the defining moment of their season, all hyperbole aside. You're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round. They need to come up with something as they get this drive started. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down. Back to throw. Man. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. Operating from the gun. Man. He finds his man, complete. That's Parsons. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Back to throw again. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and you have them staring at a third and long. And that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down. They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. To throw on third down. Man, can't get away, and he's taken down. And the defense coming through on third down, a loss of 7 to bring up fourth. Here comes the Lions punter now, as he's on here to punt it away. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Back out comes San Antonio. And now first downs are key. They want to keep that clock moving up by 2 scores as they try to cement their place in the conference championship round in 1 week's time. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. And now it looks like we're going to get a timeout here. We've got a man shaken up. While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. Second and 3. And a quick throw here, that's complete. 68 yards receiving now for him in the game. And a first down on that last catch as well. He'll look to throw. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. Call it a gain of a yard, and that'll make it second down.
Brings up second and 9 at the 34-yard line.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. He's up to 87 yards receiving now, and it's a first down.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because, to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. Second and 5.
A gain of 5 brings up second and 5 at the 42-yard line.
Now back to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions, they are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football.
Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Looking to throw. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. This will go as an 11-yard loss there on first and goal.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation because the silver lining, they took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, that still definitely hurts.
First down, a bit of a disaster, and now on second and goal, back even further. He'll look to throw. Touchdown! A great effort there with his second touchdown of the night. And the Steamers are moving closer to a date now in the NFC Championship game as they're able to extend this fourth quarter lead. Well, after their wild card round game last week, you and I said, wow, they played pretty well. Maybe they got a shot at keeping this one close. They've done more than keep this one close.
Yeah, they've made quite a statement, haven't they? And I don't know if it was the week off that hurt this defense, but they've been flat from the get-go, and that's always a coach's fear. Okay, you earn the open week, but you wonder how they'll respond with that extra time off.
And it seems like they've been running uphill all game. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. So here come the Lions now. Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a first and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard. Ready. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll manage to pick up about four at second down.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Got his man complete over the middle. It's Parsons. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. And now it looks like we're going to get a timeout here. We've got a man shaken up. The medical staff will attend to him, and we will step aside. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Operating from the gun. Man. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Operating from the gun. Man. And his throw here's incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield of man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays just like that one we saw there.
Pressure comes and down he goes. He'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack, and it's third down. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Under pressure, they got him again. Multiple rushers break through to drop him for the 7th time this game.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far.
Now they go for it on 4th, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. The Lions turned away on 4th down. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. That's another mistake there on the drop pass on 4th, and we've seen them do things like this all game.
It's not hard to figure out why they're down by that deficit. They haven't made plays that are going to keep them in the game or win the game all game long. That's another example right there. It all boils down at the end of it to execution. Either you make the play or you don't.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. They'll keep it on the ground. Monroe, and very little running room there. He did get a couple up to the 49. Third and 9 here. They'll set up a throw. And he's got his big wide receiver complete. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play. And that'll bring up 4th down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the 4th quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's our visitors with a football as we get you reset. They've got a 4th down here in a game that looks to have been decided already. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 27 yards, a big play there on 4th.
We always talk about big-time players make big-time plays and big-time moments. I think that 4th down qualified. That was a heck of a throw.
So from inside the 20, here's 1st and 10 at the 18. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. 93 yards rushing for him now as he's done it on 19 carries. Right back to him on 1st down. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. And give him 5 that time as they draw a bit closer here for a 2nd and goal. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Steamers continue to pull the playoff surprise as they lead big here on the road.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that'll increase their lead to 28. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Oh, a good-looking return set up here. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Good starting field position for him as they come up 1st and 10 at their 35-yard line. Off the play fake. Man. Looking middle, and that's complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there, it's going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
And they're moving on to the conference championship. How about this?
What a tremendous feeling to get to the game that can get you to the Super Bowl. A fantastic season. Unfortunately, for the other team, a tough, tough way for it to end.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. With that, we say good night from Detroit.